Step into a world where there's no one there.
Island of Awesome!
But the very best no MC can tell.
It's your boy, Mr. Figaro. I'm over here with the doctor, Dennis. Just hit up chest, crazy workout, you know what I'm saying?
Here you go. My background includes bodybuilding, natural bodybuilder. I won the overall 2010 state championship. I've been training for about 10 years. So that's what gives me, you know, authorization.
That's credibility.
With a lot of stuff me and Mr. Figaro were doing here.
Yeah.
And we just got down, we just got a good one. So, down
that first exercise we did was the dumbbell fell, we were squeezing in like this. What's the name of that exercise?
It's a dumbbell chest press with a twist. Basically, that's tip number two. When you use full range of motion, you're stretching your pec, that pectoral major, top part. Coming all the way down, full range of motion develops the best muscle and the biggest muscle. Full range of motion, come all the way down, come all the way up, squeeze at the top. You get in closer, there's a bigger contraction in the top of your pectoral major at the top. That's what we want. That's what that exercise that we did today focuses on, the top part. That little squeeze at the top makes all the difference. All the difference. And that's tip number two.
We started with the dumbbell flies, number one, because it's more effective. And you know, you get better results out of it. You know what I'm saying?
More or less, it isolates more. You can get that little squeeze in the middle with the little chest, so you get better muscle development with it. Yeah, I try not to exclude everything. We're not preaching don't ever do the barbell, but you know, dumbbell we get more work on, we get more bang for the time spent, the energy spent, critiquing developing, you know, our muscles. Chest.
And the Smith machine, you know, I have a bad shoulder, so the Smith machine is a good exercise to use, a weight machine to use, because it doesn't put so much pressure on your shoulders if you have a shoulder problem, and it keeps you in the same range of motion.
Right.
The Smith machine.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Smith machine is excellent. It's all about protecting your joints, doing stuff the right way. One injury puts you back. You know, and in bodybuilding, it messes you up. You can't even go to your show.
Yeah.
That's something I picked up learning in bodybuilding. You know, you gotta take care of your body. You gotta protect your joints. You gotta, you know, because you're not doing anybody any good when you hurt yourself.
Yeah.
So, what Big's saying, a lot of shoulder injuries are the result of getting on that flat bench and putting 400 or 500 pounds on there and bouncing it off your chest. Because what happens is your scapula in the back of your back can't rotate with a lot of pressure, all that weight. You can't rotate properly and transfer all the weight and to your shoulder. And a lot of us walk around, a lot of guys walk around with shoulder problems because of that flat.
So like this shit about to get snapped.
So I meet a lot of clients, a lot of people come in, they already have the shoulder problems, and a lot of that's the result of it. That flat bench take its toll on your shoulders after so much time. So that's tip number one.
Yeah. What about the exercises we didn't do? Why those four exercises?
Basically, those four are the primary pectoral major builder. That's the top part. That's what we want to focus on. So my philosophy is always, if it ain't got purpose, then why do it?
Exactly.
If you don't want to fluff, you know what I mean? I'm old school. You know, stick to what works. You know, why are you going to do all this stuff, you know, to see what people doing? It's not effective and it doesn't have purpose. It doesn't have something that you'll be trying, you know, that's focused. It's going to get you to your goal, to what we're trying to achieve.
So after the Smith machine, we went to the
cable flies. Cable flies are excellent because it's constant resistance. It's a different kind of resistance than free weights, but it's constant, and your chest is stays full of blood throughout the whole range of motion. It's constantly under the rest. Cable flies affecting from here, all the way on this end, all the way to the middle. Full contraction straight, all the way across. That's the beauty of that cable.
Mm-hmm. So
Super.
Cable flies too. We noticed we finished out the workout with the cables. Mm-hmm. A good finisher, that constant resistance, and we just burn out. Always failure, pass failure, burn. We noticed we started the workout with free weights. Mm-hmm. We're a little fresher, have more energy, so we get those big contractions and stretch and build up the chest with those free weights. But we finished out the cable, and that's a good way to finish the chest workout. The cable, burn it out.
Yeah.
So they're a good finisher, though. The cable flies. The other cable exercise we did was the bottom up chest fly, cable chest fly. Bring the cables from the bottom up to the top and squeeze it.
Yeah, man, this is my journey to getting in shape right in front of your faces. I got a lot of shows, a lot of venues coming up, and I want to look my best for it, you know? And why not show you guys my journey to get into that point where I want to be at, you know what I'm saying? So that's basically what we're doing. Paying our dues. In life, you gotta pay your dues with everything that you want. If you want something, you gotta pay your dues in it. Or, you know, if you're trying to be successful, you gotta pay your dues. If you want something in life, you gotta pay your dues in everything. And this is that journey.